Hello, Sublimation family. Well, I am back with another video on how I created glitter bags. But this time, I made my own glitter bags. It's a hack that I have that I would like to show you guys using regular craft bags, just the regular craft bags like this. You can use different sizes. I bought these from Amazon. I have the little miniature one as well. And so as you see, I have a large bag, and these all have the glitter effect on it. A medium-sized bag, and then we have the smaller bag, all with that glitter effect. And so today, I want to show you, the last video showed I had bags that I purchased from the Five Below store, and those are hard to find. Sometimes they don't always carry them. So I had to come up with a way, because my customers really wanted these bags, how to make them in bulk. And so I came up with a way to use glitter, the glitter cardstock that we use to make those clocks from Walmart. I purchased some of that glitter paper, and I sublimated on it, and then I will show you the rest in just a second. All right, so this is actually the paper that I purchased from Walmart. It's the white glitter cardstock, and so this is what I use to sublimate on. So if you see here, I have my image, and I have the glitter cardstock. Okay, just flipping them over. I am going to tape it together with my heat-resistant tape. Just put a little piece at the top, up, and then a little piece at the bottom, just to keep it in place so that it does not get off-centered. Since these here are pretty much 8.5 by actually 10.5, it fits on the regular sheet, the whole sheet, perfectly. So I'm getting ready to take it over to my heat press and press. All right, so we are here at the heat press. I am going to actually press two at a time because I have a larger size heat press here. My temperature is set at 385, and I'm going to heat press for 60 seconds. I'm going to lay my butcher paper right on top, close it down, and we will be right back in 60 seconds. All right, we have just completed our 60 seconds. Let's see how they turned out. Of course, you guys know that this is going to be pretty hot, but I'm just going to gently tear this tape off of here. And here we go. That's the first one. Came out excellent, excellent, even color all the way through. Unlike the Five Below store, that glitter paper or glitter bag, sometimes the color wouldn't come out as smoothly. So we have them here. So I am going to show you how I put it onto the bag. So I am going to now trim the edges to make sure that it fits completely on the bag. As you already see, there's still some white trim. I'm going to use my paper cutter here, trim that off. Once I get it sized to the bag, I will just simply hot glue my cardstock to the bag directly. All right, the handles, we don't have to worry about the handles coming out of place or the seam like I did before in the last video. We are simply just going to hot glue the cardstock to the bag, and we're done. So one second. All right, so I'm here with my glue gun, and what I like to do, I start the glue at the bottom edge so I can make sure I get it lined up correctly. So I will glue the bottom part of the bag in like just this U shape, just to make sure I get the edges. I'll bring my cardstock and kind of get it right there in the center, line it up, make sure it's nice and covered all on the edge. There we go. Give it a little pressure. Okay, and then I start down one side, And I will hot glue from the top all the way down. I'll glue that side, lay it, give it some pressure. Okay, we don't want to make sure that you don't have glue coming off the side, because then that will be, you might be in a little trouble because it'll get stuck to the other side of the bag. So I just try to make sure my glue is not too excessive in coming off the side. Okay, then I flip it over, and this time I glue the other side, and I actually take it all the way across the top. So I'll take it all the way across the top, glue down the side, press it down.